Hello friends, welcome again. So in this particular video, we are going to proceed with respect to the PyMOL visualization 2. So here I'm going to show you how exactly you can load one complex structure. You can get that particular complex structure directly from the PDB database of protein and ligand, or else if you have performed the autodoc vena for the same. So here you can load that particular things with respect to the complex in the form of PDB file. Okay, so we are going to see how exactly this the interactions can be visualized in the PyMOL with respect to the representations. So we are going to begin with now. So here you all can see that right now you can go with respect to the file and you can directly get the PDB, or else you can even open the particular file of the PDB which is available on your system which you have done the docking. So right now I'm going to get the PDB, and here you all can see that we can just search for the PDB 4-letter code. So you can go with any PDB ID. So right now I'm going with the one of the ID, and once you just go with the PDB ID and you have to just click on download. So here you all can see that the complex structure of protein and ligand has been downloaded on my particular PyMOL visualization tool. Okay, so here you will get the details for the same of the particular PDB with title, and then you can proceed with respect to having an overview. So what you have to do is nothing but you all can see here is the particular residues information. You can have to just click on S is nothing but show. So here you all can see that it's nothing but you will be getting the sequence of the particular structure. And here you all can see that that is a ligand, okay? So you will even find that where exactly the ligand and which are the other informations are available. So two magnesiums are there, one phosphate group is available with APD, okay? ADP particular. Here. So here you have to just go with respect to the residue if you want to select any of the particular phosphate group or the ligand group. You can even either go by selecting this one, or else you can just double click over here. So if you want to just select the particular ligand, so you can just go by selecting the particular residue from here. So meanwhile, you can even zoom and you can just have a look on the particular visualizations for the same. You all can just rotate the molecule with respect to your mouse by moving your cursor, or else you can even select the particular ligand or the protein site where you want to just select. So here right now, you can even select the particular ligand or else the residues what you require for the same. So one more thing what you can do, you have, if you want to just click on residue, so residues will be available. So, and then here you can even get with respect to the chain and then the particular residue informations for the same. So right now you all can see that here is nothing but the A action, S is nothing but the show, H is regarding the hide, and here you will get the ligand information with respect to the color. So according to this particular things, you can select the particular visualizations of your interest. So accordingly, you can even zoom out from here and you can even visualize the active selections, what you have to do. Right now we have not selected, but you can even do for the same. You can even play this option, or else you can even just go with respect to the grid options accordingly. So lots of things we can do from here. So we are going to go stepwise to explore this complex. Okay, so right now what you have to do is nothing but you have to just zoom this. So right now I'm just zooming and I'm interested to select the ligand from here, and then So right now, to get the particular ligand interaction, what you have to do is nothing but you have to go with the action from here and then look for the present, and then you can go for ligand. If you click over there, you will find the particular interactions of the ligand with the residues. So what we have to do further. So now we are going to proceed to see the particular interactions with respect to the amino acids with the ligand. And also we will just get to know some visualizations with the representations for the same. So to remove the other residues which are not interacting with our ligand, so what you have to do is nothing but we have to go with H is nothing but hide, and then you have to click on ribbon. So once you do that, you will find that the particular ligand and the residues are available with their sites of the active. So here is the step where we are removing the other residues which are not interacting with our ligand. So what we have to do further. So as you all can see that there is a hydrogen bond interaction with over here of ligand. So you have to just go ahead and just find out where exactly the interactions are available, and you have to just select that particular residues which are interacting with our ligand. And then you have to, I'm going to select now. So as I'm selecting those particular residues, so you can go and just select. And then what you have to do is nothing but now you can even go ahead and just, these are nothing but the polar hydrogens. Okay. So that exactly you will even get. And then you can even click on over here. It's nothing but the, and then you have to just extract. If you want to extract, definitely you can do that particular thing so that you can even get the further analysis for the same. So I'm going to show you how exactly you can even go ahead and just get the residues which are interacting with that particular selected residues for the same. You can even click on the residues. Now you all can see that I will just zoom and get the view from here so that we will get a clear picture for the same. We can even reset from here. So as you can see, you can even just rotate accordingly. So you will all can see that here we are getting the ligands and the interacting residues with hydrogen bond interaction. So this is how one way what you can do to get the ligand interactions for the same. Further, we can even just color accordingly. If you want to just differentiate the particular ligand, so you have to just go with the color and you can represent by the ligand from here. So I'm just selecting this. You can make a red, green, anything you need for the same. So this is how you can even do the same. And then if you want to just make representations over here, so you can just click on S, and then you can make as a surface. So lots of good things what we can do from here with respect to the particular ligand interactions to get the visualizations for the publications point of view using this particular PyMOL as a visualizations. And again, lots of things are good in visualizations, and the different features are available for the same in this PyMOL. So that exactly we are even going to see in the further videos. So stay tuned for the same, and kindly like and subscribe towards my channels so that you can get notifications for the new videos which are coming ahead. Thank you.